I like to build them on the ground. It's easier for me to see. I learned that from a rigger when I was first starting doing film work. He always make us build a mechanical advantage systems on the ground. You don't want to twist the ropes. You know, you want to make sure that the ropes running smoothly. And that's one of the reasons to build them on the ground. This mechanical advantage system that we're going to build has a built-in cam, just like that other system did, but obviously a bigger, more industrial-sized rig to be able to do that with. So you always have to start the rope somewhere. If you start at the top of a mechanical advantage system, in other words, where you're pulling from, the numbers will always be even. Does that make sense to you guys? It doesn't really matter. But if you pull from the bottom, they'll always be odd. So if my anchor is at the bottom, then it's going to be a one-to-one because I'm pulling straight up, right? Because I'm attached to the person and I'm pulling. That's a one-to-one mechanical advantage. And if I put a bend to the rope with a pulley, it doesn't give me any mechanical advantage. It just redirects the rope, correct? But if I put a pulley here and I'm pulling, now all of a sudden I've got a two-to-one. So we'll start it with a knot. And I use a lot, 11/16 rather than half inch a lot more, and it's really easy to work with compared to half inch. But a lot of the guys in the tower industry only use half inch, so that's why I do a lot of the teaching with it. Here's a knot. Bottom, right? Single the first time. You can do it with the other device, but we're gonna do it this way. Right. Top. So that's right there, a portable mechanical advantage. Now I'm going to make this a little bit easier by adding in a rigging plate. You don't have to do this, but it'll just make it clearer and you guys will be able to see a little bit easier how all this works together. So right now I have the cam on this open, right? And so if I close the cam, now I'm locked. And this is a super, super smooth pull with this system because all ball bearing pulleys, they're all relatively large diameter sheaves. And they would say that this is about a 91% mechanical advantage. So the theory of mechanical advantage is a 4-to-1, right? But then there's friction added into the system. And so you add that system up and all of a sudden you could be down to a 2.5-to-1 on a really inefficient 4-to-1 system. The only way that you can lower me is that you have to release it. Watch the cam when I do this. I'll put some weight in it, come closer. So if you see the cam, you watch it. And the only way that I can release that cam, watch it now. See how it lifted there?
Yeah.
Now you could lift that cam up with your other hand and push that button to lock it. And now it's locked open to lower. What happens if you lose control of this while you're lowering?
It should just snap down.
No, it won't. It's you, bye-bye. So there's ways to ameliorate that. You could run it through a carabiner, right? You could put a Munter hitch on it if you guys knew what that was. You could even run it through another ID and have that be your backup. But basically the system gives you a really, really smooth mechanical advantage, but does not give you the added safety on the lower of having a built-in friction device. Does that make sense? This could be an ID, which is how we'll build it next. You'll lose a bunch of mechanical advantage because the ID, you remember, you saw that, it's just a round surface, it's not spinning. And so all of a sudden you've taken it from a 4-to-1, or in this case a 3.8-to-1, we'll say, right? Down to a 3.1-to-1 or something like that. And you'll way feel the difference between those two systems. However, when I want to go to lower, what do? Just open the handle on the ID and I can lower. And if I go too fast, what happens? Yeah, it catches, it has the anti-panic. And so by building an ID into the system, it makes it a much more versatile system, but a less mechanically efficient system. So you guys, you know, as a worker, would want to determine which of those was most important, right? If you were a smaller person, and you were working with someone that was bigger, you definitely want the maximum mechanical advantage. You could also put another pulley here and another pulley here, and then all of a sudden you'd be at a 6-to-1, right? And then that would be the littlest person could raise the biggest person no matter what. But this system, right the way it's set, is a really, really efficient system, and any one of you guys should be able to raise me pretty effectively off the ground.